So you want to fully customize your metronome? Good news, you can!
So you can find the metronome settings in the bottom right corner. If you don't see them, right-click somewhere on the transport panel and make sure to check Click and Count In and Click Pattern. Now you can see these two buttons and three dots. If you drag the dots to the right, you get more. And if you can't drag because it's the edge of your screen, then you can just keep clicking on the three dots. This button activates or deactivates the metronome. The key command for this is C. The next one activates your count in, which can be very useful when you're recording. I'll show you. So after I press record, you're gonna hear two bars of clicks before the recording starts. This here shows you the click pattern that's currently active. And if you click it, there's more options, but we're gonna look at that later on. And then this E is gonna take us to all of the settings. Let's look at the general tab. This one's on and off. Here you can send the click to your MIDI out and audio out. These click options kind of tell you what they do. For example, when you're recording, you might want to hear a click during the count-in, but not when the actual recording starts. So then you can uncheck this one. Here you can set up your count-in, the number of bars, and which time signature you want it to be in. In the tab Click Sounds, you can choose what you want your click to sound like. If you have a MIDI device, you can send it there. If you want to use an audio click, which is also the default Cubase click, then you go here. You can adjust the main level here. You can use these sliders to change the pitch and the level of the individual clicks. If you want different sounds, you can choose one of the presets here. If you want to use your own sounds, click Use Custom Sounds. And now you can click here and upload any audio file. You can use percussive sounds, or you can even make a motivational metronome.
This is gonna be the take. This is gonna be the take.
Just kidding. And then the Click Patterns tab. Here you have a whole bunch of signatures that you can choose from, and within every signature you can choose or create a pattern. There's always a default one and the alternatives, and you can start the one you prefer. You can also click the pattern and adjust it. So these lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, are these four click sounds. And the bottom line is where you mute a click. You can create a new one here, and you can also delete it. To choose a time signature, you can go here and type in the one you want. So I could go 3, 4, and then you can see the pattern changed. And if I click this, I get those options again. If you use multiple time signatures in one project, then create a signature track. And you can add more time signatures using the pencil tool. And if you click here and check Show Click Patterns, and then click here or double click here, you get those settings again. Two more things. If you want to export your click track, maybe for a live performance or maybe someone you collab with asked for it, in that case, set your locators, go to Project, Signature Track, Render Audio Click Between Locators, and there it is. And lastly, if you're not hearing your metronome, even when all the settings are correct, check if you have your control room enabled, and if you do, be sure to click the blue metronome button.
So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video and also subscribe and have fun making music.